Now, Jeremiah is the one who really starts talking about Yin crying as a woman in travail. Mm-hmm. Now, he has several passages where he says so, starting in chapter 4, verse 31. For I have heard a voice as of a woman in travail, and the anguish as of her that bringeth forth her first child, the voice of the daughter of Zion, that bewaileth herself, that spreadeth her hands, saying, woe is me now, for my soul is wearied because of murderers. Listen, murderers. You're murderers. Plural. Now, chapter 6, verse 23. They shall lay hold on bow and spear. They are cruel and have no mercy. Their voice warreth like the sea, and they ride upon horses set in array as men for war against thee, O daughter of Zion. Mm-hmm. We have heard the fame thereof. Our hands was feeble. Anguish hath taken hold of us, and pain as of a woman in travail. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Now, 13. Twenty and 21. Lift up your eyes and behold them that come from the north. Where is the flock that was given thee? Thy beautiful flock. What wilt thou say when he shall punish thee? For thou hast taught them to be captains, and as chief over thee. Shall not sorrow take thee as a woman in travail? Mm-hmm. So this isn't just talking to the women, right? It's talking to the men, right? Mm-hmm. Now, Coniah, mm-hmm, in chapter 22, mm-hmm, is how you know the female, the woman, is the glory, mm-hmm, and the man is the Lord. Mm-hmm. But we're both one in Christ Jesus. Now we're going to start at 22, verse 18. Thus saith the Lord concerning Jehoiakim, the son of Josiah, king of Judah. They shall not lament for him, saying, "Ah, my brother," or "Ah, my sister," they shall not lament for him, saying, "Ah, Lord," or "Ah, his glory."
Mm-hmm.
Now, Paul in 1 Corinthians 11 says, the woman is the glory of man.
Mm-hmm.
But Adam, the first man, was made in the image and glory of God.
Right.
Now, one, though, is the image and one the glory.
Right.
But they're one in Christ Jesus. We all are.
Mm-hmm.
That's why he's greater than any male or female image.
Right.
That you use to represent the gods,
right,
in the first place. After the fall and the angels who sinned up to the flood,
right,
however long that was, right, by the way, we don't know anymore,
right.
Moses is trying to say at least 1,000 years,
right,
or so, right. It took the Lord to replenish the earth anyway.
Mm-hmm.
And the word replenish has to do with refilling it.
Right.
Not the first time, but again.
But again.
Re means again.
Right.
Plenish means make it as plentiful as it used to be at one point.
Right.
So plentiful and plenish,
right,
have the same meaning.
Right.
But he's saying replenish. Replentiful. Refill it.
Refill it.
Why? Because if we keep going on the path of Satan, we're going to destroy ourselves.
Oh, no.
And see, in Revelation, in the end, Satan and his armies are consumed by fire.
Mm-hmm.
Right, from heaven.
From heaven.
Now, yes, men can do nuclear warheads and all that.
Right.
Even now.
Even now.
They've rediscovered radiation. And can now do nuclear bombs.
Right.
But there was a village found in India when the gods were fighting.
Right.
In the Hindu texts.
Right.
That shows proof of atomic weaponry,
mm-hmm,
being used before the flood.
Before the flood.
That's all I can say about it.
Right.
Now, when did the flood actually occur? I don't know, but maybe Moses too heard of the Epic of Gilgamesh.
Right.
And heard of the man who put a boat together.
Right.
And had to wade out the flood.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Now, Moses goes a step further, though, in his retelling.
I know.
Now, he's probably borrowing from that tale.
Mm-hmm.
He's not saying it's wrong.
Right.
Either. Right. The difference is his timeline puts it closer,
mm-hmm,
to, in about within less than 2,000 years after the fall.
Mm.
So he's 3,500 years after the fall.
Right.
That's still another 1,500 years, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
Before Moses came on the scene as well.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Right. And then from Moses to Jesus is about how many years?
Right.
15,000 as well, and 1,500 as well,
mm-hmm,
or 1,500 as well.
Mm-hmm.
And then from Jesus to today is 2,000 years.
Sure.
And John talks of 10 days of tribulation. Whenever we sin against each other, we're tribulating each other.
Right.
That's what it means. And that started at the fall.
Mm-hmm.
and that produced Cain's line and Adam's line. Because Abel was murdered by Cain.
Right.
And Abel also has to do with the mark of the beast.
Right.
Now, the beast, like I told you, is trying to make you his slave by making all receive the mark. But I'm trying to warn the Christians, you're not outnumbered 2-1.
I know.
Like Jesus mentioned, if 20,000 go against 10,000,
right.
You're outnumbered 6-1.
Right.
Now, there's about 1 billion Christians,
right?
Or so. A little less of the Muslims. I'm not sure about the Jewish faith,
right?
Or Judaism,
right?
But it's kind of those three religions,
right,
are the ones that talk about homosexuality being an abomination anyway. And try to get people to not be gay. Well, like I told you, you can't make somebody who don't understand that either.
Right.
And even they are given grace for 120 years,
right,
whether they but die before that or not,
right,
to repent of their own sins,
right.
And God wants you to repent of the mistake,
right,
before you die.
We've all heard that before, right?
Right.
Or am I teaching a different doctor, drink? He shall be
think buried with